everyone. Thank you so much for joining us for Day in the Life of the Hudson and Harbor 2021. My name is Laurel Zaima, and I'm standing right here in Weehawken, New Jersey, which is about River Mile 5.6. We're right across from Hudson River Park Pier 84, and you can see this amazing Manhattan skyline behind me. So we just looked at three different sites along the Hudson River Estuary. We first looked at Swindler Cove, which is in Manhattan, but it actually samples on the Harlem River, which is a strait that connects the Hudson River to the East River. We then looked at Piermont Pier, which is River Mile 25, and finally we looked at Norrie Point, which is River Mile 85. And from these three sites, I'm sure you noticed that there was quite a bit of variability in the data that we collected for each one of these parameters. And that's because each one of these sites is located in a different location and therefore has a different aquatic habitat. However, one thing that does connect all of the sites in the Hudson River Estuary is the tidal influence. So the Hudson River Estuary starts in New York City and spans 153 miles all the way up to the Troy Dam. And because this section of the Hudson is connected to the ocean, we are a tidal estuary. So the Hudson River Estuary has two high and two low tides every single day. On a high tide, we have salty seawater from the Atlantic Ocean being pushed up the estuary, which raises the water levels as well as pushes that salt front farther north. On a low tide, we have that water being pulled out towards the Atlantic Ocean, which lowers the water level and pushes the salt front farther south. So in fact, you would be able to see these tidal changes if you spent the entire day sampling the Hudson, just like West Point did.
And so on Day in the Life of the Hudson River, we mark the tides. In fact, when Colonel Kimball was out here at 5 o'clock this morning, the water level was right here. We marked it and put a stake in. And then every 30 minutes afterwards, we put another stake in the ground, marking the line at which the water met the land. And so you can see this series of markers every 30 minutes as the tide was going out this morning. And then you can see that the distance between the markers has gotten shorter. And that's in part because the slope of the beach is getting steeper. So the water is still going out at a fairly steady rate as we approach low tide.
So while the tidal cycle and the tidal ranges can be predicted based off of the lunar cycle, there are a lot of variables that can actually drive a lot of variability. So actually, after the Day in the Life event, towards the end of October, the Northeast was hit by a nor'easter. And this nor'easter brought in tons of rain and heavy winds, and this huge influx of rain that drained from the Hudson River watershed actually completely overrode the Hudson River Estuary's tidal cycle. The Hudson River Environmental Conditions Observing System, or HRECOS, is a network of monitoring sensors all up and down the Hudson that are equipped with different sensors that are able to collect water quality and weather parameters every 15 minutes. And multiple HRECO stations actually identified that the oscillating tidal cycles were still present, but this huge influx of rain actually shifted that tidal range even higher. This fun phenomena is just an example of how weather events can really drive variability and an indicator of how unique and dynamic the Hudson River Estuary really is. Thank you so much for taking this deep scientific dive with us today, and we'll see you for Day in the Life 2022. Bye, everybody.